Welcome to Weekend Project with Stone Z56. First, you have to ensure that your Arduino IDE is a version greater than 1.8.9. This is required for ESP32 CAN, but I'm not sure if this is also required for other ESP32 modules. If it won't work, then just upgrade your Arduino IDE. I'm using the Windows Sandbox to test out, so you will give me a clean environment for you to see all the details and then all the parameters I need to set up. And later on, I will switch back to my Arduino IDE installation and we can test out the real working Wi-Fi manager. Let's go to File and Preferences. I like to enlarge the font size to 20 for you to see better. The other thing is that to get ESP32 library, enter an URL. I'm gonna leave it in the description later so you can copy it directly. Enter this URL here and then just click OK. After that, let's go to Tools and Board. And then Board Manager. Right, from there, you type ESP32 to search for the library. Oh, this is the one we want, ESP32 version 1.0.4. Just click the install. It will take a while. Okay, now the ESP32 is completely installed. Then let's click close to close the window. The next, it will select the board that you have. Go to board and ESP32 Arduino. Then select the number 2 on the list. Rover module. Next thing you need to check is the partition schema. Because I'm using the ESP32 camera, which it asks a huge memory space, so I'm gonna select huge app. Next thing is that you have to ensure you have already installed FTDI driver on your PC or Mac. Let's assume you already have the driver installed. Next, you want to ensure the upload speed to 115200. This is the default speed for ESP32. So later we can upload the sketch successfully. Now I'm going to switch back to my IDE installation on my computer. Okay, let's load the sketch to test out. Go to example, go all the way to Wi-Fi manager and let's do auto connect with feedback LED. And at this point you don't need to modify anything on this sketch, just click upload. Let's also connect the FTDI chip with your computer. Okay. For all the wiring and sketch, you can check my blog. I have a blog describing how to connect all this wiring. I will leave the link in the description later. Okay, now let computer try to upload the sketch to ESP32, but it seems it cannot connect to the computer. And usually this is caused because you forgot to connect the IO0 to ground. Just do that. Okay. Then you'll be able to upload the sketch successfully. Let's do the upload again. Okay, when you see the connecting, you just click on the reset button. Then the ESP32 will start you getting a sketch from the computer. You can see it's writing and completes at 100%. Not sure if you can see the LED flash there. Okay, it's completed. And here it says you need a hard reset via the reset pin. Let's do the reset. Wait, let's go to open the serial monitor. Okay, and then do a reset. It's waiting for download. Haha, remember I just said when you try to upload your sketch, you need to connect the ground to the IO0 pin. But now we have done the upload, so we need to unplug it. Unplug it before you can actually getting the ESP32 to work. Okay, let's do this again. Now let's click reset and look at the serial monitor. You will see the SSID and the IP address you need to access to change the password and the Wi-Fi AP for your ESP32 to connect to. For the rest, you can find my blog, have all the details about the setup. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I will see you next time. Bye.